Hi and welcome to this quick tutorial on performance counter scanning. Here we are on a asset page of a Linux machine with all the data that Lansweeper retrieves. At the top of the web console, you can see a tab for performance counter scanning. This is available for both Linux and Windows machines. At the top here, you have different filters that you can set up to take a look at just the data from the last hour or the last day or the last week, etc. So we scan the information for the CPU. We have memory information that we monitor as well as all the disks that you have, and also the network usage. So the performance counters are often used for either business critical servers or other important machines that you kind of need to keep an eye on. They've also been used for migration projects. So you can use them to kind of scope out how much resources you need for either a cloud migration or a virtualization migration to kind of, you know, get that, get a feeling of how many resources you would need either in your cloud servers or in your virtual servers. So we also added several useful reports for performance counter scanning. We heard your feedback on that. People wanted more reports for performance counter scanning. So we've added them. If you head over to the reports tab, you can simply search for performance and you get a list of the new performance reports. So we have the over 80% CPU usage. We have that for a few different metrics here. So we have it for RAM. We have 85% for CPU and RAM. Disk usage as well. And then we have some specific ones for either Linux, Windows, or for both. So if we take a look here at the performance statistics for Windows and Linux in the last 30 days, we'll kind of get an overview of all the machines that we've been scanning that have performance counters enabled. So this report really gives you an overview of all the machines that you're scanning with performance counters. And it gives, at the back here, you can see all the different metrics that we've been scanning, as well as the average, the minimum value, the maximum value, and then the identifier, which is mainly used for the disk, so you can find which specific volume that was. So since there's a lot of data in this report, just like any other report, you can use the filters at the top to kind of filter down the information and get the things that you want to see. So if we filter here, for example, on CPU information, then we'll get to see all the information from the CPU usage that has been scanned. So now that has been filtered, we just have an overview of all the CPU usage within our environment. So we can see the averages, the minimum values and the maximum values, which are quite obvious. They're, you know, minimum value is nothing and maximum value is 100. But the interesting one here is obviously the average ones. You can take a look at the average CPU usage, take a look if some of these machines might need either more resources or less resources. In this case, they're all virtual machines, so we can see if, you know, we can dynamically scale these resources so that we can maybe allocate some resources somewhere else where they're more needed. So the scan performance metrics for Linux, it's actually very simple. So under scanning, you have the performance scanning option here. And if you want to add a Linux machine, all you have to do is basically add a new target and either use an asset group that has Linux machines in it, a report that has Linux machines on it, or you can just select a Linux machine that you want to add for performance counter scanning. That's basically it. It's as easy as that. Once you've set that up and the interval expires, then your performance metrics will be scanned from either Windows or Linux machines. Thank you for watching. If you want to learn more about Lansweeper, head over to our website, start your free trial, or take a look at these videos.